Thailand, a land of diversity, a land of intimate entertainment, a true representative of Asia, a land where people from all over the globe dream to be at, a land that represents nature in its true form, and of course, a land that takes its cuisine very seriously and its people are not shy to exploit it. Thai people love to eat, period, and I'm here to experience it in its original manner.
Hi, this is Matthew and welcome to Could I Eat That? In market, what do you get? Scorpion, cockroach, grasshopper?
Everything.
Everything?
Yeah.
It's actually good.
Now that I've actually had a kind of a tease of what kind of weird food they eat, it's time for me to visit some islands and get back to Bangkok later again, trying to discover some more weird cuisines. The first island on my list is Koh Samui, which is around a 90-minute flight from Bangkok. The next island I'm going to visit is Koh Phangan, which is a 45-minute ferry ride from Koh Samui. A much smaller island in general, but it's world famous for the legendary full moon party, which is held there, obviously at every full moon.
So I'll see you guys at the full moon party.
It's time for me to head back to Bangkok, but this time I'm taking the ferry to Don Sak Pier and then the VIP bus back to Bangkok.
This is Bangkok, my friends. Let's go!
So comfortable. Chitujat Market is the weekend market in Bangkok and is very, very popular amongst the public and a must visit if you're in Bangkok. If you want to see Thailand in a nutshell as a whole, then there is Rose Garden you could visit through tour agencies for about 450 bahts. Rose Garden is about 40 minutes away from the city and just ahead from the floating market. It's the best place for one to see the entire tradition and culture of Thailand as they portray it through organized acts.
I have eaten this, I have eaten that, I have not eaten this. Frogs. Slowly done.
The one weird and bizarre cuisine that is found in Thailand commonly are the insects. They eat all kinds of insects, which are mostly roasted or deep fried and are still crispy. But some of them still carry some insect juice within them. How they are caught is better left unsaid. Whether you actually find cockroaches, bugs or grasshoppers, believe me when I say they ain't bred in a hygienic place. So the roadside dirt, the garbage, the farm or the agricultural feeds are likely places you could find them where they are caught and fed to the public.
This is where the show ends, unfortunately. I'm so happy it's ended. So this is Matthew signing off, but before I go, always ask yourself this question, that if you were in a country like Thailand or anywhere else where you have weird food like this, could you eat that?